Hello friends, welcome back to my channel, and in our today's session we are going to learn about the future perfect continuous tense. Okay, 12th tense form. Okay, that is the last tense form. Okay, so we have already learnt about past tenses, present tenses, and three of the future tenses as well. This is the last one. Okay, so here also we are going to learn very interesting things, how to use this tense form, how to conjugate it with nouns and pronouns. We are going to learn with so many examples for your better understanding. Okay, so stay focused, let us start today's session. So this is the tense that we are going to learn today, the future perfect continuous tense. Okay, the future perfect continuous tense is used to refer to an action that has started, will be continuing for some time in the future. Starting time can either be past or present, but it will be continuing in certain future time before another action or event. Okay, this is really important. Whenever we use future perfect continuous tense, we need to mention the other action or event that is associated with this continuing action. This is really needed, essential. Then only it will be a correct usage of the future perfect continuous tense. Okay, there is nothing difficult about it, but you need to learn and understand the basic things thoroughly. Look at the example. By this November, I'll have been living in Delhi for 15 years. So here, starting of the action is in the past, that is before 15 years. It will be continuing in future time as well. I am not going out of Delhi. Okay, so it will be continuing in future time as well. We haven't indicated the completion of the action, but we mentioned that at certain future point of time, this action will be continuing. That's it. Okay, so we are talking about this November. By this November, that's what we are talking about. Okay, I did not mention that I am going out of Delhi. Okay, I'll still be living there only, but by this November I'll have been living in Delhi for 15 years. That's it. Okay, like the future perfect tense, the future perfect continuous tense is also used with time expressions. This is really important. Many of my students make a mistake over here. Okay, so we are not supposed to use these expressions alone. They can't stand on themselves. Okay, so we have to support it with another action or event associated with it. Okay, either a period of time like for 2 hours, for 3 years, for 5 months, or a point of time like next June, next Monday, coming Sunday, at 6 a.m., at midnight, etc. You can use either of the time expressions. Can it be a period of time or it can be point of time? Okay, examples. I'll have been reading this book for 2 hours by 6 p.m. So I have started the action in certain past time and it will be continuing in certain future time as well. Okay, so by 6 p.m. I'll have read it for 2 hours. That's what we mean to say. Okay, I'll have been reading this book for 2 hours by 6 p.m. By 2020, they'll have been living in Paris for 10 years. Okay, here period of time we mentioned 10 years. Okay, they are not going to go out of Paris. Okay, we are not mentioning the completion of the action over here. That's what you have to understand. Okay, stative verbs or non-action verbs like to be and to seem, to believe, to know, can't be used with the future perfect continuous tense. Okay, they are used with the future perfect tense instead. Okay, stative verbs, we know they don't carry ing forms. That's why we are not supposed to use future perfect continuous tense with them. Okay, opt for future perfect tense instead. Look at the examples. By this October, I'll have been knowing you for a year. This is incorrect. It's meaningless. It's insane, isn't it? By this October, I'll have been knowing you for a year. It's really crazy. Instead, by this October, I'll have known you for a year. This is the correct usage, okay? Know is verb of perception, stative verb. It doesn't carry ing, okay? Next session, I'll have been understanding the concept of tenses. Now, this is also incorrect, crazy sentence. Understanding is the activity done by your brain. So, stative verb, verb of perception. It doesn't carry ing, okay? It's not an action verb. It's a stative verb. And next session, I'll have understood the concept of tenses. This is the correct way of using it, okay? So, verb of perceptions, non-action verbs, don't carry ing. So, don't at all use perfect future perfect continuous tense with them, okay? Opt for future perfect tense. That's it, okay? I have heard so many people using this understanding, okay, like an action verb. Are you understanding? People ask. Now, this is really wrong. We are not supposed to use verb of perception with ing. We can't make them as action verbs. Are you able to understand? Or do you understand? Have you understood? Did you understand? It should be like that. Are you understanding is really wrong. Okay? Please don't at all do that mistake ever. And forming the future perfect continuous tense. Its main verb is present participle, that is V1 plus ing, and its auxiliary will have been. Okay, you have to use all these three whenever you use future perfect continuous tense. You have to use will have been along with V1 plus ing. Okay, it's so simple. It seems really strange because future perfect tense and future perfect continuous tense are very less used in our day-to-day communication. Okay, they are rarely used. That's why every sentence seems to be incorrect for us. But with proper practice, we'll be able to overcome that obstacle. Okay, we will be able to use these two forms of tenses very easily, and it enriches our vocabulary as well. Okay. Verb conjugation with nouns, singular and plural. Affirmative, will have been painting. Negative, won't have been painting. Interrogative, will Ram have been painting? Negative interrogative, won't Ram have been painting? So here, don't get confused. Along with singular, we are using have. We have to use have because we have auxiliary will over here. All modals, okay, they take first form of the verb only. So we are not supposed to use will has or will had. We have to go with will have. That's it, okay? Don't get confused. Of course, it seems really incorrect. Will Ram have been painting? Really, it raises a question. Is it a correct sentence? Of course it is. It is the only correct form of using it. Okay, so don't get confused. And with pronouns as well, it's like this only. Pronouns I, we, you, he, she, it, they, will have been waiting, won't have been waiting. Here, will plus subject plus have been waiting, right? Will I have been waiting? A negative interrogative. Won't we have been waiting? Okay. So, this is the verb conjugation with pronouns. Okay. So, this is future perfect continuous tense. Hope I have made the things clear to you. Okay. Now, let's go to our favorite part of the lesson, quiz. This is a very simple quiz. You have to fill in the blanks. That's it, okay? When I finished this course, I have left four blanks over here, and its main verb is learn computers for 6 years. By the time I turn 40, I have left four blanks over here. Main verb is play the guitar for 45 days. And the third one, you see this question mark, right? So it is interrogative, and that too negative interrogative. Okay? So its structure is won't plus subject plus have plus been plus present participle, V1 plus ing. Okay, so here main verb is sleep. When I come back from the office, negative interrogative. Next one is also an interrogative. It's not negative interrogative, it's an interrogative sentence. Okay, so it starts with the helping verb will. Will plus subject plus have plus been plus V1 plus ing. And it's here main verb is study, okay, at 8 p.m. And the last one is a negative sentence. So it has not over here. Okay. So I have left four blanks over here. Main verb is eat at 7 a.m. tomorrow. Okay. So this is the simple quiz. I hope you will check your learning with this simple quiz. And let me know your doubts and suggestions as well. So friends, this is about the future perfect continuous tense. Hope you all have understood the lesson. Still you have any doubts, please let me know by writing in the comment section, or you can contact me through my mail ID as well. Okay. Thank you so much for being with me. Meet you soon, guys. Bye-bye.